Welcome to our channel Learning Math. In this video, we're going to solve an extra geometry problem for grade 9 for official exams. Before starting and for the continuity of our channel to support you by more and more information, please like, share and subscribe and with a great appreciation for your support. Now let's start together. Consider the two circles C and C prime of centers O and O prime, respectively. C and C prime are tangent externally at E. We have AE and EB are the diameters of C and C prime such that AE equals 4 cm and EB equals 6 cm. Also, the tangent AM to C prime cuts C at a point at which we should draw the figure and then calculate the length of AM. As you see here, we have a circle C of center O and diameter AE equals 4 cm. We have another circle C prime of center O prime and diameter EB equals 6 cm that is tangent externally to the circle C at the point E. Well, the tangent AM to the circle C prime cuts the circle C at H. First of all, we should keep in mind that when we have a tangent, then it's perpendicular to the radius. So here we have an angle 90 degrees. Now they are asking us to calculate the length of AM. Note that here we have a right triangle AM O prime. In a right triangle, can't we apply Pythagoras theorem? Note that we have the length of A O prime, we can add them 2 plus 2 plus 3 is 7, and we have the length of the side O prime M, which is a radius in the circle C prime, so it's equal to 3, then we can easily find the length of AM using Pythagoras theorem. Well, how to apply Pythagoras theorem? We start by the hypotenuse squared, which faces the 90 degrees, so A O prime squared equals AM squared plus M O prime squared. Now we just replace each side by its length. A O prime squared is 7 cm squared equals AM squared, we copy it the same, plus M O prime squared, which is 3 cm squared. Now we just solve them, so 49 cm squared equals AM squared plus 9 cm squared. We need to find the length of AM squared, so we move 9 cm squared to the other side. Now plus becomes minus, so 49 cm squared minus 9 cm squared equals AM squared. Now we can say that AM squared equals 40 cm squared. But we need to find the length of AM and not AM squared. Well, in this case, to remove the squared, we need to put radical. We can either directly put AM equals radical 40, or we can say that AM equals plus or minus 40, then we explain that minus is rejected since length. Then AM is radical 40 cm squared, so it's 2 radical 10 cm. Note that 40 is 4 times 10 and 4 is 2 squared, so it's 2 radical 10 cm. Now in part C, show that HE is parallel to MO prime. Then deduce the lengths of HE and AH. If you note something, here we have given that the tangent AM to C prime cuts the circle C at H. And we should keep in mind that whenever we have a point on a circle, then we will have an angle inscribed facing the diameter. So here we have AHE salient will be 90 degrees. Well, if you know something, we have proved that the angle AMO prime salient is 90 degrees. And we also have here AHE salient is 90 degrees. It's an angle inscribed facing the diameter. Then we have HE and MO prime are parallel to each other since they are perpendicular on the same line. So we can, here, since we have them parallel, we can apply Thales' theorem. Why do we apply Thales' theorem? These two parallel lines are cut by intersecting transversals. If you note something, we can say that AH over AM equals AE over AO prime equals HE over MO prime. Now we can just replace each side by its value. Since we need to find AH, then we use the fraction containing AH, and we use another fraction that has all its lengths given. Note that AE We have its length 4 cm and AO prime. Its length is 7 cm, so we can directly use it. Also, we have given AM, which is 2 radical 10. We should keep it in mind. We have just proved it. Now we can say that AH over AM equals AE over AO prime, and we replace each side by its length. If we move 2 radical 10 to the other side, divided becomes times 2 radical 10 times 4. It gives us 8 radical 10 over 7. So the length of AH is 8 radical 10 over 7. Now what about the length of EH? Also, we can use the fraction containing EH with AE over AO prime, since we have both lengths. So we can say that EH over O prime M equals AE over AO prime. Now O prime M is a 3, since it's a radius of the circle. C prime is half the diameter, and we have AE is 4 over AO prime, which is 7. Now we also move a 3 to the other side, divided becomes times 3 times 4, 12, so EH is 12 over 7. Now in part D, the parallel to AM through E cuts O prime M at I. Prove that HEIM is rectangle. Well, we need to draw the parallel to AM through the point E. This parallel cuts O prime M at I. Now we need to prove that HEIM is a rectangle. If you know something, we have HE is parallel to O prime M, in particular parallel to MI, proved, since they are perpendicular on the same line. We also have HM is parallel to EI, given. Now can't we say that we have a parallelogram? Each of its two opposite sides are parallel to each other. Now if you know something, in this parallelogram we have a right angle, which is HMI salient. We have proved it. Well, a parallelogram, when it contains a right angle, it will become a rectangle. Therefore, we can say that HEIM is a rectangle. Now, in part E, the tangent to C prime at B cuts MO prime at N and AM at K. In part A, we need to prove that KO prime is perpendicular to AN. So, here is the tangent to the circle C prime at B, as you note here. This tangent intersects M O prime at the point N, and it also intersects A M at the point K. Now we need to prove that K O prime is perpendicular to A N. If you note something in the triangle K A N, well, aren't we having in this triangle A B perpendicular to Kn, since Kn is tangent to the circle C prime at B. So here we have the first height, which is AB. Something else, we have N, M is the height, or it's perpendicular to AK. We have it given. Since we have here AM is tangent to the circle C prime at M, so here it's 90 degrees. Now we can say that NM is a height or altitude in the triangle KAN. Well, how many altitudes did we find? One, two. Two altitudes or height. These two heights intersect at the point O prime. Now can't we say that this point O prime is an orthocenter in the triangle KAN? Therefore, we can say that K O prime, which is issued from the vertex and passing through this orthocenter, is the third height in this triangle. So we can say that K O prime is perpendicular to A N. Now, what is the nature of triangles K M B and K A N justify? Let's see together. In triangle K M B, note something. Can't we say that KM is equal to KB as tangents issued from the same point to the same circle C prime? Well, we have two sides that are equal. Now, can't we say that triangle KMB in this case will be isosceles at K? Well, what about triangle KAN? If you know something, we have O prime M equals O prime B. You may ask me, what's the relation between these two sides and the triangle? Here we have O prime is equidistant from M and B. Also K is equidistant from M and B. Now we have two points equidistant from M and B. Can't we say that K O prime is the perpendicular bisector of MB? Well, but we have proved that K O prime is also perpendicular to AN. Now can't we say that the two sides A, N and MB are parallel to each other? They are perpendicular on the same line, which is K O prime. Well, since they are parallel, then we can have corresponding angles. So we can say that KMB salient is equal to the angle KAN salient. They are corresponding angles. And also we can say that KBM salient is equal to the angle KNA salient. These two angles here are corresponding angles also. Well, but if you note something, we have just proved that this triangle is isosceles. Then here we have two base angles that are equal to each other. Now, can't we say that in this case, we have K, A and salient will be equal to K, N, A salient? Therefore, triangle K, A, N is isosceles at K. Now, show that A, M, B and N belong to the same circle whose center and radius are to be determined. Well, if you note something, here we have a triangle A, M, N is right at M. Its hypotenuse is the side facing the 90 degrees, which is A, N. Also, we have the triangle A, B, N is right at B. Its hypotenuse is the same side AN, which faces the 90 degrees. So we can say that we have two right triangles having the same hypotenuse. Therefore, we can say that the points A, M, B, and N belong to the same circle, which has the diameter AN. So its center is the midpoint of AN, and its radius is half the diameter AN. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe.